Understand. Are there any questions?
Hey, watch it, baby. This cat is heavy on religion.
I can see this has become a struggle between good and evil. Satan has a question.
Yes, sir, Chaplain Gill, but since neither one of us are God, I don't think either one of us are in any position to say who's good and who's evil.
Why don't you just ask your question?
We were discussing the disciples. What color were they?
Well, I don't think we know that for certain.
But they were Hebrews, were they not?
That's right.
As was Jesus. Jesus was also a Hebrew.
Why don't you just ask your question?
What color were the original Hebrews?
I have told you that we don't know that for certain.
Then you can't believe for certain that Jesus was white.
Just a moment.
God is white. Isn't it obvious?
Well, that is obvious, but we don't know if it's obvious that God is white. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us that Jesus did not have blonde hair and blue eyes. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us that the images of Jesus that are on prison walls and churches throughout the world are not historically correct, because history teaches us that Jesus was born in a region where the people had color. There's proof in the very Bible that you ask us to read in Revelation's first chapter, verse 14 and 15, that Jesus had hair like wool and feet the color of brass.
Just what are you saying?
I'm not saying anything. I'm proving to you that Jesus was not, and I might quote one of our Indian brothers, he was not a pale face. Amen.
These books wrapped up. It's dangerous if people know you're reading them.
Well, apparently I'm dangerous already.
Well, I guess everybody knows, you know what's in those books. But you got to be careful about letting people know everything you know. That's what happened to them prophets.
Which prophets are you talking about, Professor?
Jeremiah, Isaiah, Amos, Hosea. Them Israelite prophets.
I'd better get out of here before you have me swimming in the head.
We believe in the truth that is in the Bible, but we don't believe in the lies that the white man has put in the Bible. We believe in a lot of prophets and the scriptures they brought to the people. We believe in the resurrection of the dead, not in the physical resurrection, but in mental resurrection. We believe that the so-called Negroes are most in need of mental resurrection. Therefore, they will be resurrected first. We believe in the resurrection of the dead, but not when you're physically dead. No. When you stop breathing and your heart stop beating and that man stick you in the ground, that's all she wrote. Right. You are not going anywhere. Your soul isn't going anywhere. Your body isn't going anywhere. Nothing is happening after that. When you're dead, you are done. Right. That's it. You can forget it. Then if that's all of it, what about the resurrection? He says that our people are dead. Negroes are dead. Walking zombies. You're the one that the book is talking about who is dead. Dead to the knowledge of yourself. Dead to the knowledge of your own people. Dead to the knowledge of your own God. Dead to the knowledge of the devil. Why, you don't even know who the devil is. You think the devil is someone down inside the ground that's going to burn you after you're dead. Why, the devil is right here on top of this earth. He got blue eyes, blonde hair, white skin, and he's giving you hell every day. And you're still too dead to see it. We believe in the resurrection of the dead. We believe that the 20 million black people in America in the last day will be taught the truth. The trumpet of truth will sound in your ear. That is being sounded today, the trumpet of truth. And this truth strikes your ear and strikes your heart. It'll open your eyes. It'll open your ears. It'll make you stand up. It'll do the same thing for you that truth did for the dry bones in the valley. Because the picture of dry bones in the valley is talking about you. The picture of Lazarus laying dead 4 days is talking about you. You are Lazarus. You are the dry bones. You are the prodigal son. You are the lost sheep. You are the people about whom the Bible is speaking who will stand up in the last day when the trumpet is sounded. Black people are waking up. Black people are standing up. Black people are rising up, and they're throwing fright into that knee-shaking white man. We believe we are the people of God's choice. That's what we believe. We believe we're the chosen people. We don't believe Jews are the chosen people. We don't believe Jews are the ones going to the promised land. We don't think Jews are a part of God. No, Jews are nothing but another part of that same race of devils that come out of Europe. They didn't even come out of the Holy Land. They come out of the caves of Europe. A Jew, a Frenchman, an Irishman, all of them the same thing. A race of devils. They got different kinds. German. thing. Just like you got a German Shepherd, an Irish Setter, a French Poodle, a Chihuahua, but they all dogs. We furthermore, we believe we are the people of God's choice, as it is written that God would choose the rejected and despised. And we can find no other person fitting this description in these last days more than the so-called Negroes in America. We believe in the resurrection of the righteous. We believe in the judgment. We believe this first judgment will take place as God revealed right here in America.
Right.
The judgment will take place in America. The resurrection will take place in America. The judgment will take place in America. The separation will take place in America. And the destruction will take place in America. Doom will take place in America. Doomsday will take place right here. This is the place the Bible is talking about. When the Bible mentions Babylon, it means America. When the Bible mentions Sodom and Gomorrah, that's America. When the Bible mentions Egypt, that's America. This is Rome. This is Babylon. This is that wicked kingdom that God is going to come and set flame to in the last day. And you're living in that day right now.
Right.
And I'm glad.